Welcome back to Dark Corners Streaming. We've never reviewed a series before, but one based, albeit loosely, on the stories of Edgar Allan Poe was always going to get our attention. New to Netflix, The Fall of the House of Usher takes its inspiration from the Poe short story, bringing it up to date.
But where to start?
And dropping as many references to other stories as it can along the way. As in the story, the title has a double meaning in the physical house and the dynasty, off-screen, as it were, in the book, but here, very much central.
Six kids by five mothers, but they're all mine.
All subservient to Roderick Usher and his sister Madeline, the rulers of a pharmaceutical empire currently being investigated by state's attorney C. Auguste Dupin. Who else? With the bulk of the story told in multiple flashbacks, which I'm sure will continue as the series progresses. And just to be clear, although the whole series, with its name-dropping episode titles, is available, we're just reviewing episode one for now, partly to avoid spoilers.
Well, come on if you're coming.
The first third of the episode hits the horror. Sensibly making sure to get this in up front, because then we're into courtroom drama and the lifestyles of the rich and vile subgenre currently popular.
Let's see what a few years of your worth taste like.
Beyond those showy name checks,
Goldbug will show him that the Usher Empire should be a matriarchy.
There are allusions and images from Poe that are part of the narrative rather than just lip service, but make no mistake, this is the horror succession more than any attempt to adapt Poe.
My confession.
I'm fine with that. Poe is hard to adapt. The majority of the stories are more tone pieces than strict narrative, and as you will know if you've seen our special on the Roger Corman Vincent Price Poe films, please subscribe, liberties have to be taken and can be taken without losing the spirit of the original. This, for me, is where the series so far disappoints. It is very creepy at points. It has atmosphere and opulence, but not really to make me think of Poe. It lacks the decaying grandeur that is intrinsic to his work generally and Usher specifically. The physical house may be boarded up, but that's because it's abandoned, and members of the house, the family, live elsewhere in pristine sterility. The family may be falling, but it lacks the sense of organic decomposition linked to that house.
1979. May it rest in peace.
More importantly, for me, it lacks the sense of the unseen, the unknown and unknowable, world off its axis that permeates Poe, and which the Corman film captures very well. It's not natural, it's not supernatural. There are no answers, it's just something in the air. So, as it stands, this fails as Poe. That said, as the horror succession that's just using Poe as a gimmick, I quite liked it. I'd like to see more of Mark Hamill. I hope the characters of the children will move beyond one note they're all horrible cliché.
See if Cartier will make a platinum plate.
Because if they stay this broad, that's me done. But as it stands, I will watch more episodes and maybe we'll talk about them. We'll see how this one goes. Thanks for watching. For my own take on Poe, then please check out my book, The Wolf, the Raven and the Black Cat. There's a link in the description below. What are your thoughts on this opening episode or the whole series? Please avoid spoilers. Let us know in the comments below.